This is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we will discuss some problems on Ackermann steering systems. At the end of this session, student will be able to solve problems on Ackermann steering system. This is the learning outcome of today's session. Ackermann steering gear mechanism. In this, the entire steering gear mechanism is situated to the back of the front axle. Now here we can see, in this particular session we will first look towards the turning circle radius. When a vehicle is taking a turn, that time what is the turning circle radius of all the four wheels? Now here you can see, this is the angle of outer turning wheel, outer front wheel, and this is the angle of inner front wheel, that is theta. Now if we see in this case, form a formula for a inner front wheel, outer front wheel, inner rear wheel and outer rear wheel. So first of all, I will calculate the turning circle radius for outer front wheel, and that I will designate as ROF. Now ROF is what? Here I to this distance is nothing but, that is ROF, turning circle radius of outer front wheel. Now first of all, I need to find out the distance from this end to this end, what this will be. Now here we can see, this is the triangle from which I can find out this particular length. Now here I can see, and if I call this as a ROF, so this becomes B upon sine of phi. This becomes sine of phi, this much distance. So plus, now this much distance is remaining. So this is nothing but, now here A is nothing but the track length is there, and C is nothing but the distance between the two pivot, and B is nothing but the wheel base. Now to calculate this particular distance, we have to consider this track length and distance between the two pivot, and this much distance is nothing but A minus C by 2. Therefore here I will write A minus C by 2, and from this particular formula we will get the radius, turning circle radius of outer front wheel. Now we will discuss regarding turning circle radius of inner front wheel. Now again the same is there, here only the theta angle is there. We have to first calculate this particular distance from this I point to B point. Then that particular distance, if I calculate, then that is B upon sine of theta. And I need to go in a reverse way, that is minus this much distance. And that distance is again same, that is A minus C divided by 2. Now we will come towards these two rear wheels. Now I will consider first outer rear wheel, that I will designate as ROR. Now this ROR becomes, now if I say I need to calculate I to this particular distance first. So for this purpose, if I take tan of phi, then I will get tan of B upon tan phi, that much distance ROR. Then then afterwards I need to calculate this much distance that I need to add, that is again same, that is A minus C by 2. This is the turning circle radius of outer rear wheel. Now I need to calculate last one, that is turning circle radius of inner rear wheel, that I will designate as RIR. Now this can be calculated as this much distance if I take, then if I take the right angle of this particular theta, then I will get B upon tan of theta that I will get. Now I need to calculate this much distance, that is again the same, that is A minus C by 2. So from these four particular formulas, we can able to calculate the four different turning circle radius for different wheels. And we know that for correct steering, this equation must be satisfied by our steering mechanism. That is, cot phi minus cot of theta is nothing but c by b. So this equation, if our steering system is satisfying, then definitely that time we can call it as our steering system is correct, and that time all the wheels are rolling perfectly. Now we will see the problem that is based on this particular equations. Now I will read the problem. A motor car has a wheel base of 2.743 meter and pure center of 1.065 meter. Now here wheel base is given. I will write the given data for it. So given data is nothing but that is B we have seen, that is the wheel base, distance between the two axle 2.743 meter, and distance between the two pivots is given, that is C 1.065 meter. And next one, that is track width, the wheel track is given, that is A 1.217 meter. Calculate the correct angle of outside lock and turning circle radius of outer front and inner rear wheel when the angle of inside lock is 40 degree. Now here we need to calculate phi first, and after that I need to calculate the turning circle radius of outer front wheel and turning circle radius of the inner rear wheel. So these three things I need to calculate. For that purpose, for correct steering, what is our formula? Cot phi minus cot of theta is equal to C by B. Now here I know theta is what? Theta is 40 degree, that is given, that I need to write over here. Therefore, cot of phi is equal to, that is C is nothing but 1.065 divided by 2.743, and here plus this cot of 40, that is theta. Now I need to calculate this particular distance, that is why I need to use a calculator. So if I find out this particular distance, then what should I do? Now here 1.065 divided by 2.743. If I do this, then I am getting 0.3882. So here I will write 0.3882 plus. Now this particular, whatever the cot theta is there, that is 1 upon tan. Therefore 1 divided by tan of 40, if I write, then 1.19175 will be the answer. If I add this to this particular two figures, then 3882. So this becomes 1.579. So this is cot of phi. And now if I calculate this particular cot phi, then I need to calculate 1 upon this particular tan. Therefore 1 upon answer is equal to, if I do the tan inverse of this, then I will get the angle, that is phi is equal to 32.3 degree. That answer I am getting. So phi I got first. Now second thing that I need to calculate is, that is ROF. ROF, how to calculate ROF? Now ROF becomes, already that we have seen what is ROF. ROF is nothing but B upon sine of phi plus here A minus C divided by 2. Therefore B is nothing but, that already we know, 2.743 here, and here sine of phi now we have calculated, that is 32.3 plus A, that we know 1.217 minus C, we know, that is 1.065 divided by 2. If I calculate this, then I am getting ROF. So from this calculator we will calculate 2.743 divided by sine of 32.3. This whatever the figure is there, 5.133 I am getting, 133 plus the bracketed quantity is 1.217 minus 1.065. This divided by 2, I am getting 0.076. If I add these two things, then I am getting 5.209 means 5.209 meter. This will be ROF. This is my first answer. Now, second thing that I need to calculate is the radius of inner rear wheel. That formula is B upon tan of theta minus A minus C divided by 2. Now here again B that we know, that is 2.743, the same thing. Tan of 40 over here because theta is 40, and A minus C, that is 1.217 minus 1.065 divided by 2. Here I will calculate the first thing, that is 2.743 divided by tan of 40. So whatever this quantity is there, that is 3.268 minus 0.076. Whatever this quantity is there, that quantity is nothing but RIR, that is nothing but turning circle radius of inner rear wheel, 0.076. So this is nothing but 3.2 meter that I am getting. This is the RIR. So in this way, you can solve the problem regarding this Ackermann steering gear mechanism. These are the references. Thank you.